Austin is just full of, you guys, it's like the land of hipsters, right? Can't get enough of them. I just saw this guy walking, I was walking down Congress, this guy's like, he's like in his 40s, wearing a flamingo onesie, just like carrying an old-fashioned typewriter, just like looking for pussy. Like they figured it out. Girls don't want to fuck Pauly D anymore. They want to fuck some Charles Manson looking greasy dude with the beard acting like he's Ernest Hemingway. If Ernest Hemingway were alive today, he would beat the shit out of every hipster. There would just be trails of bloody hipsters outside every artisanal coffee shop and beard waxing facility. You know what I'm talking about? Like these people who have to like wear their coolness. Like, not me, I have style, that's different. But like, see these guys walking around with like, you know, Mork and Mindy suspenders and a tattoo of a parallelogram. And they're just like, they can't even light a pilot light. Like, try to wave, they're like, hey, hi. And they always like have new names for themselves. I'm Nathaniel. Okay, I'm sure your parents named you Nathan. In college, you were probably called Nate Dog. Nathaniel, that's like the name of a ghost. Not an emaciated barista with a Mr. Pringles mustache and a gluten sensitivity. Why do only hipsters get gluten allergies? Are they activated by American Apparel purchases? I was talking to my friend, he's like 38, barely ready for pet ownership. And he's just like, I think I'm gonna get into pickling. You should get into employment. These are the guys we're supposed to procreate with. This is the guy I'm gonna trust to be the sperm donor to the Asian surrogate that's gonna carry my child. That is a big decision in a gal's life.